Kevin. I'm here.
Eve.
Sweetheart. Darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand. Stand by me.
It's another beautiful day.
Says who?
Well, guess I don't have to ask how you're doing this morning.
You know, if you want our best work, you should really do something about the facilities around here.
Is the mattress lumpy, Princess?
We could use another bed.
Care to share the joke?
Oh, your friend's all right, Thorhart. First time I ever heard a request for separate beds from a whore.
Your Jack, who's actually our Jack, who's my Chandler, is Chris Ramsey's brother?
Except I just wish that the two of them could get along because I just like them both so much.
Because they're both, you know, both pretty hot.
Yeah, Chris and Jack are both cute. That's the easy part.
Hey, so how did you guys hook up in the first place? What, your face is turning red. What is that?
I didn't know he was in the river, and he didn't know I was on the shore. And when he came out of the water, he was totally naked.
What? Oh, my God, shut up. Are you serious?
It's not like I saw anything. Hey. I mean, I closed my eyes and turned away, and all I wanted to do was run.
Yeah, like towards him. But you didn't, did you?
No, I didn't. He was so sweet. Oh.
Yeah, what a nice icebreaker. Hello, I have no pencil. Nice to meet you.
But it's been so incredible. I mean, we have this amazing connection where we understand each other without the, I don't even know how to describe
No, you don't have to, because Jamal and I had the same thing, so I totally understand what you're talking about.
But on the other hand, Chris is, like, totally freaked out. He doesn't trust Jack at all.
But they're brothers.
And they don't act like it. I mean, I'm an only child, and I always thought having a brother or sister meant having someone you can count on forever.
You know, all those years, I always wondered what it would be like when we finally came back together again. Gotta tell you, it's nothing like this.
Sorry to disappoint you.
You don't give a rat's ass. You made that clear from the moment you saw me. You didn't recognize who I was. And you still don't know me.
You're a small town punk hustler who's just working an ankle.
Yeah, I used to. And that's how I got through. And then Mom and I found each other again. And we became a part of something, a family. And that changed everything. That's all she wanted for us, was to find your brother. That was her dying wish, was find your brother. Be a family again. Well, there I am, Chris. Now it's your move.
I cannot believe that you actually think this is good for you.
I thought you'd be proud of me.
Proud of you? Proud of you for what? Finishing off a whole fifth before breakfast?
No, I'm following your wisdom, Lucy. I'm getting out. I'm seeing old friends. Life's a party, Lucy.
You have to be conscious to enjoy it.
Is that a comment on my sobriety?
No. No, I am just saying there are a lot of other ways to move forward, to put one foot in front of the other.
You're absolutely right. Come on.
Where are we going?
We're going dancing.
Oh, Doc, come
no,
on.
Lucy, you're telling me to put one foot in front of the other. Well, I can do that right here on the dance floor, and I'm not taking no for an answer.
Okay, if this is what you want to do, this is what we'll do.
What? Am I that bad or something?
No, you're a wonderful dancer. You've always been a wonderful dancer. But, Doc, listen to me. You're pushing yourself way too hard.
Lucy. You can't have it both ways.
You don't have to do this, okay?
Yes, I do.
No, you don't.
I can handle this.
Eve. No, you can't.
I can't. What? You can't?
Handle this? Honestly, no, I can't. I can't pretend that this is you, that this is okay. I can't pretend it's okay that you almost killed us in that fire because you drank too much and now you polluted yourself so much this morning that you want to dance. No, I can't handle it, okay?
Are you gonna try and change me again?
Oh, no, I'm gonna take you home, get you to bed, and you're gonna go to sleep, okay? And I'm not taking no for an answer. Come on. Hold on.
You will never, ever say another word about the lady. Is that clear?
Let's not kid ourselves, Thornhart. Yeah, you know she's not a... You don't know, do you? Oh, you forgot to share your colorful history with him, did you?
You lion scum.
Confession time, princess.
He's telling the truth, Ian. I used to be a prostitute.
Leave.
I'm just curious, but is it success that makes you paranoid, or were you born that way?
It's in our genes, Jack. Trust no one.
No. See, Mom was never that cynical. She'd have hated this. Maybe it was a good thing she died before we found you.
Well, that's a pretty lousy thing to say.
You know, she had this whole idea of you, Chris. Thought you were the smart one.
Why didn't she try to find me?
Hey, she said she'd drive across the country if she had to.
There are online services, private investigators.
Private investigators.
You really don't get this, do you?
We were scraping for burgers. All right, so how in the hell are we supposed to afford some computer or hire some PI to come find you?
Okay, fine.
Oh, well,
how much?
What's this?
How much is it gonna cost me to make you drift away from Port Charles?
I don't want any of your offerings, big brother. I'm gonna walk out of here. But I'm not leaving. I'm not going anywhere till I'm ready.
I don't care who you were or what you did. He will not talk to you in that way.
You're pushing it, Thornhart, considering the circumstances.
No, you're pushing it! You need both of us to fight this disease, so I suggest you back off.
You are in no position to be threatening me.
Let me make this perfectly clear. You insult Eve, and you die.
You have work to do in the lab. Don't let me stop you.
Ian.
Hey, he's just trying to get you. Put it out of your mind.
I've seen that look on a man's face before. I know what he wants. And it's only a matter of time before he tries to get it.
Come on, wait, just a second. Okay, good, now I want you to go sit on that couch over there, go sit.
Sorry, Lucy, my obedient days are over.
No. First, you're going to sit, then you're gonna eat, and then you're gonna go to sleep.
I don't wanna sit or eat, and I don't wanna sleep. I wanna dance.
Oh, Doc, no.
No, I like dancing with you. Don't you like dancing with me?
I love dancing with you, but now is not the time.
Oh, I'm surprised at you. You try and name a better time. I dare you.
Oh, brother. Okay, one dance.
All right, we'll just make our own music like we used to do. Oh, this is nice. Champagne. We should have some champagne. It's Tuesday, isn't it? We could celebrate Tuesday.
No, you know, you're not yourself, Doc.
Oh, now. I never felt more like myself.
But with everything that's happened, you know,
what?
You need
to
just...
What? Are you saying that you don't like this, Lucy? Are you saying that we don't fit?
No, but...
But nothing. This is us. This is you and me. We were great. Oh, we were great. We were better than great, Lucy.
Doug. Oh. Oh, Doug.
Listen. No.
Doug, wait.
No. Don't go.
Your problem is, okay? okay, is that you trust Chris, but Chris doesn't trust Jack. But Jack makes you go weak in the knees, and that kind of clouds your judgment.
Okay. So what are you saying?
You just need to trust your instincts.
I'm not even sure what my instincts are saying.
So then maybe you should just give yourself a break from both of them. Just long enough so that you can listen to what your heart is telling you.
No, you're right.
Okay, cool. So then we'll talk again. You know, maybe we can go to the mall or something.
Yeah, I'd like that.
Yeah, me too. Okay, so incoming. Think and breathe. Think and breathe. And now I gotta try and picture him not sopping wet and weak.
Stop it!
Hey.
Hey. How'd it go with Chris?
Like I expected.
What, did you guys have another fight again?
Not exactly. Look, hey, why don't we go someplace? Take a walk or something, you know, so we can talk.
Yeah, that sounds like a really good idea. But you know what? I have to get back to Lucy's place because I have some stuff I have to take care of.
Oh, you have to go now?
I really do, okay? But if you just give me a call later, I would love to do something, okay? Bye.
Yeah, listen, I have a job for you. No, I have a problem, an old one. I don't know what to say. It just sort of caught up with me after a lot of years. Can you meet me at my place? Yeah, no, as soon as you can. I want to make this go away now.
No, we might want to try a less acidic medium. That last culture obviously didn't take. What?
Tell me what you saw in Harris' face.
Human nature. I used to tell myself that what I did for a living didn't matter.
It doesn't matter. Not to anyone who knows you.
Thanks. But I've seen that look in a man's face before. When he knows that you've slept with people for money. He looks at you different. Like he can own you.
Every man.
There have been exceptions. I married one of them.
I will kill Harris if he touches you.
Look, you don't have to defend me, Ian.
We all have a past. We did what we had to do at the time. They have no right to judge you.
Oh, but they do.
Well, then let them. They're sad, boring little lives. Whatever you did has made you who you are today. And who you are is Anne, a brave, strong, wonderful woman. Don't let them take away one second of your life, okay? You're an incredible doctor, you're an incredible woman. And whatever it took to get you there, that's your badge of honor. Don't let them take it away, please.
Don't stop there, it's just getting interesting.
So, Dr. Lambert, let's get back to work so we can get out of this dump and get you back in your husband's arms.
Right. That's the idea. You are drunk.
Yes, I am, Lucy. But I know what I want.
This is absolutely not right.
You said you wanted to help me.
I do.
Then help me now.
Tell me what you want me to do.
I need you.
I
I need to feel you. Touch you. Remember all those places that used to be mine.
I'd only been gone like a few hours.
Right, well, you know, don't let it happen again.
Ooh.
So what's in the bag?
Something I never thought I'd be buying for a woman until now.
Truffle oil?
Yeah, and a whole lot of the things that have never been on my grocery list before. I was figuring maybe you could, you know, whip me up one of those fancy schmancy dinners.
We can afford this and rent.
Well, yeah, you know, we can now. Yeah, I mean, I'm not trying to get all respectable on you or nothing like that, but you are looking at a man with a J-O-B.
Aside from the fact that we're being held hostage by a raving lunatic, this is a lot like those all-nighters we used to pull in meds.
At least here we get room service.
Oh, great. Just like the Roach Motel. You can check in, but you can't.
Hey, we'll get out of here. Just gonna save Harris. What we really need is,
a telephone.
A little bit of hope. A little bit of faith. Didn't you once say we made a great team?
God, you know, it's amazing. The way this parasite just destroys every bit of tissue in its path. It's the perfect predator.
Not quite perfect. Harris is still alive.
You know what? I want him dead just as much as you do. The only problem is we have to save his life before we can get out of here.
Okay, and then we'll kill him later. Always think positive.
Either you're extremely sleep-deprived or you're channeling Pollyanna.
I channel Brad Pitt if it make you feel better.
Brad Pitt isn't exactly my type. You know, when I felt bad, Kevin always used to do this funny thing.
He must be missing you terribly. Let's see how much you.
Doc.
Only you. You can make me forget Eve.
Eve. Oh, boy, this is wrong. This is so wrong, Doc. It's so wrong. It is. It is so wrong. It's wrong.
Stop it! Stay away from her! So give me all the details about your job, you know, so I can brag about you. When do you get your first raise or promotion?
Stop. Look, don't go buy me a briefcase or nothing like that. It's just a job. That's it.
Well, what kind of job? Do you have a female boss who I have to kill?
Look, stop. All right. Stop asking me all these questions, okay? All you need to know is that I'm doing this so we can have a better life. Okay?
That's cool.
I want to do things to you. Oop, I mean, for you.
I love this.
For us, baby.
I love the sound of that. Mm. Okay, so. I will stop being so nosy, but for now, we need to celebrate. So as soon as I catch a break, I will go whip you up. The best dinner would even make Martha Stewart weep.
You know, forget about dinner, okay? I got a better idea how we can celebrate. When's your next break? Huh?
It's now. It's right now.
Yeah.
Okay, come on. Hey, Victor, will you cover for me for a minute? It's an emergency.
Thanks, man. Life goes on.
You know what we need? A change of scene. So I've been thinking about a romantic getaway.
Yeah, but
and
Gabby,
Denise
listen.
Told me about these cabins up at Lake Rains. It would be so wonderful to wake up to the sound of birds, to wake up to the smell of campfires, just to wake up to you.
Gabby, as much as I want to go away with you, I'm sorry, I can't.
You know, it's not polite to stare.
I know. Sorry. That's just that I owe you a thank you.
For what? Getting into this mess?
No, not for that. For defending my past when Harris threw it in my face. Thank you.
We've all had a past. You don't need to apologize. Not to anyone. Not you. Not ever.
Well, I think we need a break. Huh?
Sure. We're not on the clock.
So tell me, what's the first thing you're gonna do if and when we get out of here?
Haven't thought about it.
Oh, come on. You must have at least one fantasy. Tell me what it is. Please?
I don't believe in fantasies.
Everybody has one. Just share with me. What? Come on.
Okay. There's this little island just south of Borneo where the water is 25 different shades of blue and the beaches go on forever. And most of all, it's far away from civilization.
So what, you'd go live there all by yourself like a hermit?
Mm-hmm. I mean, I would extend an invitation to the right person. What about you? What do you dream of?
Going home, back to the people and the place I love. That's heaven to me.
Well, then the sooner we get you back to Kevin, the better, right? Okay, just gotta figure out why the drugs that work on other people do not work on Harris.
Right, well, it must be the virulence of the parasite. We need to find out how to get rid of those little critters.
I'll be damned.
What?
Take a look.
Oh my gosh. The level of infection in the tissue sample has decreased. Does this mean that maybe...
It means you gotta run more tests, but okay. Not now. Let's take a break. My brain's fried.
Yeah, that's a good idea. You know, I've got a crick in my neck the size of Texas.
All right, well, I'll take care of that. Put yourself in my hands.
Ian, do you think that you'll ever get to your island and I'll ever get home?
I promise to get you out of here. So I will.
Oh, Livvie. I didn't expect you to be home.
You said she would be back till later. We didn't think you'd be back till later.
Yeah, obviously. Lucy, are you all right?
Yeah. I'm fine.
We're fine. I'm okay. We're fine. We're dandy.
But are you drunk?
No,
yes.
No.
What is going on? Lucy, your blouse.
It's the snaps. You know, it's shoddy craftsmanship. I gotta talk to that tailor who made this. It's really a poor job.
Yeah, well, it looked like Kevin
no,
was...
No, I know. It's not what it was.
Well, something was going on.
Smart girl. She's a very smart girl.
God, I can't believe you're here like this drunk and trying
Look,
to...
Look, no, Livvie, stop. This is not what you think is... You don't understand, see? Doc was just having a bad day, and he needed to talk to somebody, and I was listening.
No, you
that's
don't
all.
Have to make excuses for me, Lucy. It's time Livvie saw who I really am. Livvie, it's time you saw your real dad.
No, it's not.
You see, the truth is, Livvie, I'm sorry to disappoint you. I'm sorry to disappoint the whole world, but I'm no knight in shining armor. I'm just a man. I'm just a man who's fresh out of answers and clean out of clues. And I'm sick and tired of being a role model for everything that's noble and good. St. Kevin has left the building.
Well, I see exactly who you are.
No, Livvie, wait. Wait!
Every morning, I gotta tear myself away from you. And when we are apart, all I think about is coming home to you. And taking you in my arms like this. And showing you how much you mean to me.
Why don't you show me again, then?
I'll make this up to you. Big time.
You don't have to.
I mean, it's not about a trip. It's about being with you.
And you know how much I want that.
Maybe there's a way we can have it all.
What do you mean?
Well, I know a cozy, romantic spot where we can get away and still be close.
Where?
My apartment.
Livvie, I was just thinking about you, about how lucky we are to have you in the family.
Yeah, well, no offense, but I don't think I want to be any part of your family. One crazy family is enough for this lifetime.
I am trying to help you, but I cannot do that if you're going to be a jerk to me and to poor Livvie.
See, I don't need this.
Really? Why don't you just go ahead and wallow in your own self-pity, but you're going to do it alone by yourself.
Fine with me. You know, I think having your wife die in the arms of her lover entitles you to a little wallowing.
You do not know that is what happened. Look at me. What happens when I'm in trouble? You come to me and you say, Lucy, you get a grip. Well, Doc, that's what you need to do right now. You have to stop and get a grip. Or are you too afraid? Is that it? You're afraid
you're
to follow your
own advice? You're not listening to me, Lucy! The whole time she was with me, telling me she loved me, she was thinking about another man. Do you have any idea what that feels like? I'll tell you what it feels like. It's killing me. And I want to mourn my wife, but I can't because I'm so angry.
Okay, well, then be angry. You know what? I think you're right. You're right. You know, Eve doesn't deserve mourning. She was nothing but a conceited, self-centered witch who never thought about anybody but herself.
Shut up. Don't you dare say that. Don't you dare talk about her like that. You didn't know her. You didn't know it like I did. She was kind. She was giving. She was warm. She was loving. She was so loving.
Boy, you got great hands.
It's either be a doctor or be a masseur.
At this point, I'd say you missed your calling. Oof.
I can go all night.
Knowing what I do about you, I'm sure that's possible.
You think you know me, huh?
Not really. I don't know what touches you, what moves you, what you hate, and what you love.
Let me get on with it.
Okay.
Like single malt Irish whiskey. I like the smell of my father's field after a long rain. And I like anything by O'Neill. Because he infuses everything, even hopelessness, with the power of passion.
So we've got O'Neill, your father's field, after a rain, and Irish whiskey. What else?
Children. They hope for the future. They make you believe that anything's possible because to them it is.
Yeah, you know, that's true. When I was a kid, I wanted to grow up and be something spectacular. Really make a difference, be special.
Well, you've achieved your goal. You're very special, Eve.
I think maybe we should get back to work now.
I want you in bed.
What?
Let me fight the evil parasites for a while. You go get some rest.
Oh, right. Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
I'll wake you if I find anything.
Okay.
To get a job and take care of me and everything, but you do know that you have nothing to prove to me, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll just take back that little red Corvette I got for you then.
I'm serious, Jamal. Look, we have food and a roof over our heads and each other, and that's, you know, all that we really need.
Okay, and we'll see how you feel when those lights get cut off, too.
Oh, and I see it's all the way that you look at it, because there's plenty of things that we can do in the dark. And I hope the first thing they do is shut off the phone.
Ouch. Sorry. Hello. It's for me.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go take a shower.
Take it with you.
Okay, we'll be quick and meet me in there.
All right. Give me 1 second. Like I told you, I was cool about starting tomorrow. All right, but come on, call me my cell phone if you need to talk to me. I don't want my girl to find out what I'm doing, all right? All right, peace.
Tomorrow, your place, we start with dinner.
Maybe we could skip dinner, go straight to dessert.
That sounds like a plan.
The reason my apartment's such a great retreat, it's quiet. It's comfy, and there's no checkout time.
Oh.
And maybe I shouldn't be talking to you about this, but I just walked in on Kevin practically accosting Lucy, and it really freaked me out.
Kevin and Lucy have a very long history, Livvie. I'm sure that he wouldn't be doing anything to hurt her.
No. But Kevin was so out of control. I've never seen him like that before. And I already had one parent go psycho on me.
Well, I can understand your wanting your father to be perfect, but my son's a wonderful person. It's just that the way the world works is that he's a human being, and that means he's flawed.
I guess I just thought I could have one person in my life who wasn't.
You don't know who Eve really was, Lucy. You have no clue what she really meant to me.
I think I do.
We loved each other. We shared a wonderful life.
So you have to fight for her. You have to fight for Eve, Doc. You have to fight. You do. You have to fight to try and save all those wonderful good memories you have of Eve. Please don't let them be ruined by some half-written note you found in Ian's apartment.
What he wrote about her, Lucy. I mean, it sounded like they were having an affair right under my nose.
You don't know that. Maybe it was just Ian, you know, being Ian and writing some crazy limerick because there's a lot of words that rhyme with Eve.
I don't believe you're talking about Eve like this. The two of you never really even liked each other.
No. But I like you, Doc. I like you very much. So you see, you can't doubt Eve. She would not want you to doubt her. You have to fight. Fight for the woman you love. You fight for Eve.
Ian. Ian!
Hey, you had a bad dream.
Oh, God, Ian.
I'm not going anywhere.
Good.
You're the most beautiful woman I've ever seen. And I can't deny this any longer.
Ian. I've been wanting to do this for so long. Ian! Ian!
Hey, you must have had a bad dream. You all right?
Seat taken?
I was beginning to think maybe you stood me up.
No, I was, you know my barber Caputo? He's actually being sued for some bad haircuts.
I'm sorry. listen, do you think we still have time for lunch?
If it's okay with you.
Yeah, well, I mean, we got the board meeting and all, but it's okay with me. Why wouldn't it be?
Well, I heard about the fire at the lighthouse and everything.
Oh, that, yeah. I didn't inhale that much smoke, trust me.
You sure you shouldn't be resting or something?
I'm positive. What is with you? I'm not in the mood for this cross-examination.
I can see that.
You can? How come?
Well, when I came in, the look on your face, it's, you know, when your world has just gone upside down.
You got me. It's, Kevin. He is really at a loss over all this, and I feel so terrible for him because I want to help him, but I think I've done just the opposite.
Why would you say that? You're a good friend to him.
Yeah, but I wasn't brave enough just to come right out and tell him the truth.
Now, what truth are we talking about?
That his wife was really in love with another man.
Oh, God. Oh, God, now I'm fantasizing about him. Oh, God, okay.
Dear Kevin, I can't tell you how much I miss you, how much I want to be in your arms right now. If this letter somehow manages to reach you, just know that I love you. And I always will.
Morning.
Hey, Ian.
What you doing?
Nothing. Just doing research.
There's no need for that anymore.
Well, what do you mean? If we're gonna cure Harris, we're
have finished.
To
do... We're finished.
What?
I came up with something that'll get us out of here.
Oh, no, you're crazy. Harris will never go for that.
He doesn't have a choice. What else?
Please. Don't stop talking on my account.
Don't you ever knock?
Oh, why should I? Unless there's something going on in here I'm not aware of.
How are you feeling, Harris? You look like hell.
Thank you for your very professional assessment.
Trouble breathing?
A bit.
Chest?
What is it?
A regular heartbeat. Means the disease is progressing.
What do you intend to do about that?
We'll try putting you on digoxin.
What is that?
It regulates the heart.
We still have to find out the underlying problem, because if not, you're going to have a fatal heart attack.
But we are doing everything we can to find a cure.
Why haven't you found one yet?
Well, we might have had a bit of a breakthrough last night.
Last night? You discovered something last night?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell me? What do you...
We hadn't completed the tests. I want to make sure it works.
And we're still running more tests, just to make sure, so...
What kind of game are you playing, Thornhart? You have something to help me, or don't you?
Yes, but the treatment's very dangerous.
What is it? What does it involve? Is it surgery? Is it radiation? Is it drugs? What
no,
is
it's very simple. All you have to do is take a dose of this.
What is that?
Poison.
How'd you know I'd be here?
Well, when I couldn't get a hold of you, I figured you'd turn up at your mom's place.
Yeah, well... You know why? Why are you here?
Because I needed to see you. And... my guess is you need me to.
Denny, hey, thanks for coming over.
Yeah, it sounded urgent.
It is. It's about that little problem that I have.
Does a little problem have a name?
Yeah. Jack Ramsey. It's my kid brother.
You want me to find him?
No, I want you to help me get rid of him. Permanently.
Remember, I told you before, I really didn't want to believe it. But it's true.
Lucy, how do you know?
I saw this note that Ian wrote to Eve.
What kind of a note?
I guess it wasn't really a note, you know? It was just a line he'd written, and it wasn't really delivered, I don't think. I mean, she didn't read it, but it said they kissed. They actually kissed, so I know they were having an affair. They were together.
Lucy,
I know what I'm talking about, Scott. I do.
I thought that you didn't say anything to Kevin.
I didn't. He knew already because he saw the note. I think that's why he got so drunk and almost died in that fire.
So you think that he saw this note and that he thought they were fooling around?
That's what he said. So then, of course, he had to ask me if I knew. And I said, no, they weren't. They're not. They couldn't be true. Because I couldn't do it to him. I couldn't make him suffer like that.
You did the right thing, Lucy.
I did the right thing. I told him a lie, a huge, big lie. This is not like a little white lie. This is a huge lie.
Eve and Ian are dead, okay? So what difference does it make now? At least Kevin has the memory of his wife is intact. I mean, he has his dignity left.
Yeah, maybe you're right, but still, it galls me to know that I sat there and allowed Kevin to believe that two-timing hussy is some sort of saint.
Two-timing? Lucy, are you listening to yourself at all?
I'm sorry. I know, I called her a hussy and she's gone. I'm sorry, because I know you really liked Eve, but what she has done is unforgivable.
No, this isn't about Eve, it's about you. You're falling back in love with Kevin.
So you gonna move in here?
I don't know yet. I just thought I'd come by and get the place cleaned up and go through some of my mother's things.
This has gotta be so tough for you. I mean, I'm kinda going through a lot of the same stuff.
You and Chris.
And it still blows my mind that he's actually my brother.
Oh.
Okay. All right. You've got to tell me what's going on here.
What do you mean?
You're acting different.
Am I?
Yeah. Hey, did Chris tell you something?
No, Chris didn't tell me anything, but Alison Barrington did.
Alison Barrington? You got to be kidding me. That whacked out...
She happens to be a really nice person.
All right, maybe she is a nice person. All right, but what did she say to you?
That you took money to pose as her boyfriend.
Oh.
Yeah. Which actually... wouldn't be a big deal, but then I think about what Chris said and...
Come on, Livvie, don't tell me you believe that.
Look,
crap.
I don't know. I have been wrong about every single person I've ever trusted.
Well, I'm not like that.
No?
No.
I can't help wondering, are you really this great, caring, sensitive guy that I thought you were? Or are you playing me?
Is that what you really think? You really think I'm... falling for Doc again?
Well, it's just that I know that look in your eyes. I've seen it before.
I don't know what to say.
There's nothing to say. We've just both gone through some changes.
Yeah, right. So, you know, I hear you're sort of, you've been seen with Laura Spencer.
Yes, I have. I guess we're both jumping in the time machine, aren't we?
Yep, I guess that's what we're supposed to do, huh? Sort of try and move on.
Yeah, but it doesn't make it any less...
sad?
Very sad.
Yeah. But, you know, us, we'll get through it, right? We always do.
Of course, Lucy, because we're always gonna be pals.
Yeah, always. And we share a child, you know, and that's... we'll always be connected. But you know what? It's more than that. We are so much alike, and we know each other better than anybody in the whole wide world, you know?
And that's why I'm saying, when I say this to you, that I think you should just drop this thing with Ian and Eve, because it's not going to do you or Kevin any good.
Yeah, but why would he do that, you know?
First of all, maybe he never sent the note, and maybe the kiss never really existed.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I never thought of that.
Yeah, because the kiss didn't actually ever happen.
Okay, maybe you're right. Maybe I should just forget the whole thing, huh?
Yeah, because it might have been something that he maybe had fantasized about that he just kind of wrote down for the hell of it, but it was never followed through. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Then I should try to drop it.
Absolutely drop it, because no good is going to come.
Right. Okay, I will. I'll try, okay?
Okay, no, listen to me. Just repeat after me. I'm going to drop this.
Okay. I don't have to do the repeat business. I will. I swear on your hair that I will drop it. I will never bring up even Ian's alleged love affair ever again.
Poison? You want me to take poison? Are you out of your mind?
It's the only chance.
You think I'm a fool?
If I were gonna kill you, do you think I'd tell you it's poison?
I would think you'd have to, knowing that whatever you gave me, I would have analyzed
first. If you would just listen
for
one
second. You know, you cannot be trusted. I know that now. You know, after today, you're gonna be in a lot of trouble.
Harris, please wait. Just let us explain.
Yes,
okay?
You do. Explain to me how taking poison is gonna make me well. I'm so curious to hear that.
It is not the poison that will cure you. The parasite in your system is blocking any kind of treatment that might fight this disease.
If we don't kill the parasite, there's nothing we can do for you.
And just so coincidentally, the poison is the only thing strong enough to kill it.
Yes, that's what the research shows us.
Ian told you there might be some kind of risk involved.
We're only giving you enough poison to attack the parasite. Shouldn't be enough to kill you.
Shouldn't isn't good enough. Find something else.
No, please wait, Harris, please.
What?
Look. We have done every experiment, tried every treatment possible. There is no other way. I want to go home. I want to go home to my husband.
I wouldn't worry about him if I were you. I mean, a woman like you is just so easily replaced at the right amount of money.
That's enough.
No, Ian, please. I don't care what he says.
I care. This woman's been working day and night to save your twisted life. Only that she can get out of here and go home to her husband. No one's playing games here. You either take your chance with the poison or you die.
You know, I think it is something.
Oh!
It's somebody reestablishes who calls the shots.
How exactly do you expect me to get rid of Jack?
Just let me worry about that. Just dig up as much dirt on him as you can. Believe me, there'll be plenty.
Now what? Threats? Blackmail?
Whatever it takes to get him out of town.
Going off a lot of trouble. Take you two have some bad history.
Well, this is, really isn't about me. I'm doing it for someone else. And believe me, she's definitely worth the trouble.
You're doing this for some chick? Is that what you're telling me?
It's really none of your concern, Danny.
Jeez, I hope she isn't another serial killer.
Yeah, well, Livvie is nothing like Julie.
Livvie? That's a girl you had me track down her father.
Danny, I just said this is none of your concern.
So what? You're in love with her?
Love really has nothing to do with it. Wouldn't make that mistake twice.
Then what do you want from her?
Denny, you ever like to play with clay when you were a kid? You know, you mold it, shape it, turn it into anything you want.
So you're gonna mold her into your perfect woman? Sounds a little weird if you ask me.
I didn't ask you. Just get the goods on Jack.
Because he gets in the way of your plans for the lady.
Once I get Jack out of town, Livvie will be mine, just the way it should be.
Livvie, I don't know what I can say to convince you. Maybe nothing. I mean, obviously, I can see that you have some big trust issues here after everything that happened with your mom.
This is not just about my mother.
Look, I know, all right? A lot of people have let you down.
Yeah, I thought it was all over, then yesterday.
What? I mean, what happened?
I caught Kevin, my father, yeah. In this really... It was not a good moment.
And now you don't know what to think of him either, right?
Or you. I mean, suddenly you're Chris's brother.
You gotta believe me, I'm just as shocked as you are.
I mean, tell me, you really didn't know?
No! Livvie, a lot of people have disappointed me in my life. And I've lost beloved ones, too.
I know. And how did you deal with your mother dying?
Still working on that one.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. I was so hard on you.
Hey, look, it's no big deal, okay?
Like, I really, really do want us to be friends.
So do I. Right?
Good.
Well, maybe I better get going. I know you got a lot of stuff to pick up here, so.
Yeah, I do. I have a lot of stuff to do. So. You don't have to go.
Yeah, I have to go.
Well, then I really appreciate you coming by, because I always feel better after I talk to you.
Well, that's what I wanted. I really...
Okay.
Yeah. Bye.
Hey, Jack. I'm gonna see you soon, right?
Yep. I'm not going anywhere.
Bye.
Hey, Colleen.
Can I help you?
Yes, it's me, Lucy. I want my messages. Board member, nurse's ball, remember me?
Oh, Lucy, I'm so sorry. Here you go.
Oh,
forgive
thanks.
Me, I'm just a little rattled.
Rattled? Why are you rattled?
Well, I'm trying to print this lab report, and I can't get the stupid computer to work.
Oh, well, you know what? Let me take a look.
Do you know computers?
Oh, well, yeah. You know, I think I have set the world's record for shopping by email, you know? I do it every day, and also, I used to help Ian a lot, you know, with his computer programs. Okay, so what do you have here? You have a DNA report coming in about the explosion. Is there a problem?
No.
No. You know what? I think I see that you have sort of a minor glitch here. I might be able to help you if you want me to work on this. If you don't mind running to tell the board, I'll be a little late.
Great. Sure.
Okay. Thanks, Colleen. There is a 99.9% probability that the victims in the car wreckage are not a match to Eve Lambert and Ian Thornhart. Oh my gosh! They didn't die. They didn't die in the explosion.
I'm telling you, Harris, the poison's legit.
So is this knife.
You brought me here to do what no other doctor
would. I didn't ask for Dr. Kevorkian.
For the last time, I'm not here to kill you. I'm trying to save all of us.
That's a good try, Thornhart. I'm not buying it.
Fine. Why hurt Eve?
You know the rules. I die, we all die. The gentleman that I am, ladies first.
Wait. You want me to prove to you there's not enough poison to kill you?
Get down. No. No.
Okay with this. I wouldn't have offered if I weren't. Now get out of here before I change my mind or Mom shows up.
Okay, I'm going. But if anybody needs me,
I know you're just a phone call away. Oh, and yes, I've got Gabby's number and her cell and yours.
All right. And if Mom asks,
Joe, don't worry. I know the plan.
Okay, I'm gone.
Okay.
Frank.
Yeah.
Thanks. I just want these couple of days with Gabby to be perfect, you know?
How could they not be?
Yeah, you're right. What could go wrong?
There is a 99.9% probability that the victims in the car wreckage do not match Eve Lambert and Ian Thornhart. They didn't die. They didn't die in the explosion. They're alive. They're alive.
So they weren't in Ian's car, only Eve's wedding rings were, but how could the rings be there and Eve not be unless... Oh, they planned the whole thing to make it look like they died when that bomb exploded so they could run away together without anybody knowing. Only now, once this comes out, everybody will know. Oh, no. It'll rip Doc apart if he finds out the truth from a report. I have to tell him. I'll just find the right way to do it in just the right time. But in the meantime, nobody can see this report.
Wait. I'll prove there's not enough poison to kill you.
Ian, don't.
You're either insane
or telling the truth. The poison will attack the parasite, not you.
Still, I'll wait for my dose until after you recover from yours.
Just get out.
I'll leave you to your suffering. If he dies,
you'll be the first to know.
I have found the perfect team to save my life, Ian. The true hero in Eve, she's beautiful and smart. The perfect man and woman, absolutely. I have no... Oh. I have no doubt.
Get your hands off me. And don't expect me to lift a finger to help you until I know that he's all right.
That's understandable.
Don't ever touch me again.
If I do?
Get out, Harris. Hanging over our shoulders is not going to help us do our best work.
I never thought I would be in a position where I hoped you'd live. In this circumstance, surprisingly enough, I do.
Are you crazy? The whole point of taking that dose of poison was to kill a parasite.
I know what the point was.
Yeah. But you don't have a parasite. Therefore, we don't know what this is going to do to you. What were you thinking?
I was thinking I should stop him before he puts a knife in you.
Really? Do you really think he was going to kill me, Ian?
Didn't want to take that chance.
Oh, man. Fine. You know what Harris said about you is true. You always have to be the hero.
Only when it matters.
You drank poison, Ian.
Yeah, not enough to kill me.
You don't know that.
Sure I do.
No, you don't.
No, I don't.